Deep in the basement of the Stanford University Library, hidden among the volumes of Homer and Shakespeare, is Stanford's fastest reader. It's a robot invented in Switzerland that can scan up to 1,000 pages an hour. It turns the pages itself, even blowing air to separate them when they're stuck together. Stanford's librarian, Michael Keller, says this robot has a giant reading list.
Our goal is to see how much of these 8 million volumes that we have gathered here, how much of that can we make accessible and more available because they've been digitized.
Until now, converting books into data that can be put in a computer was a very slow job, done by students or low-cost workers overseas. That limited the number of complete books available on the internet. But it won't for long.
The internet presents us now with a way to make them more broadly available and more deeply available.
Just a few blocks off campus, Christopher Warnock is already building a virtual library of the future.
The computer's awesome at finding information. It can do it faster than anything else.
Warnock's company, eBrary, has partnered with Stanford and nearly 200 other libraries and publishers to make each of their digital collections available online. In addition to books, there are maps, scientific papers, even sheet music, a giant database people pay to access. It takes the power of the computer and applies it to the written word.
We're searching within what is, you know, plainly a digital scan of this book. And, you know, if we search for every occurrence of love within this document, we can find it much more quickly and efficiently than if we had to go through and read, you know, the entire book.
Finding love made easy. And there's another benefit. Old books digitized can be preserved. No more fear that the paper will turn to dust.
So I think of this project as a kind of witness protection program for the past, run by librarians.
It is very much a revolution, and I think very much a revolution to the benefit of one and all.
Not a cheap or a short revolution, though. It's estimated that digitizing the 8 million books in the Stanford Library could cost $250 million and take at least a decade. Even for a robot, that's a lot of reading. Ned Potter, ABC News, New York.